Come on, everybody. You are on the channel for English for Biology Majors, which is brought to you by 慈济 University's Susan Ye. We hope after you learn this class, you will think biology is fun and to read biology book is piece of cake. Let's go. Yay. Hello, everyone. Today we are going to start with lesson 18, which is prefix and suffix related to taste and smell. But first, we need to review what we learned last time. For carboxylic acid, we can use these prefixes and suffixes. The prefix is carboxy, C-A-R-B-O-X-Y. And the suffix is O-A-T-E and O-I-C acid. For C-N triple bond, the cyanide functional group, we can use the prefix cyano, C-Y-A-N-O, or the suffix nitrile, N-I-T-R-I-L-E. For SH functional group, we use mercaptol, M-E-R-C-A-P-T-O, this prefix, or we can use thiol, the suffix thiol, T-H-I-O-L. For amino functional group, we use the prefix amino, A-M-I-N-O, or in suffix amine, A-M-I-N-E. For NO2 functional group, we use nitro, N-I-T-R-O prefix, or suffix A-N-E. For halide, we can use the prefix halo or halo, H-A-L-O, or suffix A-N-E. For this functional group, we can use the prefix carbamoyl, C-A-R-B-A-M-O-Y-L, or carboxamide, C-A-R-B-O-X-A-M-I-D-E, or amide, A-M-I-D-E. For ester functional group, we use the prefix R-oxycarbonyl, or the suffix O-A-T-E. And for ether functional group, we use alkoxy, A-L-K-O-X-Y, or the suffix A-N-E. And the last one, the functional group C-O-C-L, we use the halocarbonyl, H-A-L-O-C-A-R-B-O-N-Y-L, or the suffix oil halide, O-Y-L, H-A-L-I-D-E. Now let's move on to lesson 18, which are prefix and suffixes related to taste, smell, and also some other thing that can be smelled or eaten. First one, for a sharp or sour taste, we use the OX or OXY. Our example for OXY is oxyphilic cell. Oxyphilic cell can be cells of the parathyroid gland that increase in number with age. The cytoplasm of the oxyphilic cell or oxyphil cell contains numerous mitochondria and stands with eosin. And also, it can be used for eosinophil. Eosinophil is also love acid, so it can be called oxyphilic cell. For sweetness, we have four prefixes to use: gluco, G-L-U-C-O, or glyco, G-L-Y-C-O, or Melly, M-E-L-I, or Melito, M-E-L-I-T-O. Let's see our example. For glucose, our example is glucosamine. Glucosamine, as shown in this figure, is an amino derivative of glucose. Let's see the structure of glucose. See the difference between the number 2 carbon here, the OH functional group is being replaced by the NH2 group. Glucosamine is a component of polysaccharides such as chitin. It is marketed as a dietary supplement, supposedly to reduce the symptoms of arthritis, but it is kind of controversial though. Our example for glycol is glycocholate. Glycocholate, as shown in this picture, is the structure of glycocholate. It's also called glycocholic acid or cholinglycine. It is a crystalline bile acid involved in the emulsification of fats. It occurs as a sodium salt in the bile of mammals. Our example for MELI is melibiase. Melibiase is an old name of alpha galactosidase. This PowerPoint is a structure of alpha galactosidase. It is a glycoside hydrolase enzyme that hydrolyzes the terminal alpha galactosyl moieties from glycolipid and glycoproteins. It is encoded by the gene named GLA. Our example for MELITO is maltose. What is a maltose? Maltose, actually the modern name for maltose is raffinose. Raffinose is a trisaccharide comprised of galactose, glucose, and fructose, and it is widely distributed in many plants. The raffinose's old name is maltose. Let's review what we've learned. For sweet or sweetness, we can use any of these 4 prefixes. Gluco, G-L-U-C-O, glyco, G-L-Y-C-O, meli, M-E-L-I, or malito, M-E-L-I-T-O. For base, we can use this prefix, baso, B-A-S-O. Our example for B-A-S-O is basophil, basophil, or basophil. It's any cell that has granules stained by basic stains, but especially for the granular leukocytes, it is specifically called as basophil. For bitter, the taste, bitter taste, we can use this prefix, picro, P-I-C-R-O. Like bitter squash. The example for picro is picrotoxin. Picrotoxin, as shown in this picture, is the structure of picrotoxin. Picrotoxin is a poisonous material extracted from the seed of the Indian berry, which is shown in this picture. It can be used as a stimulant, and the picrotoxin is a complex of these 2 alkaloids. For food, we can use the prefix cito, S-I-T-O, tropho, T-R-O-P-H-O, or the suffix trophy, T-R-O-P-H-Y. Our example for cito is cytophobia. Cytophobia, also called anorexia nervosa, it is a morbid or insane dread of eating and aversion to food. The first documented case is this Miss A. She has cytophobia, or we say anorexia nervosa. In 1866, she looks really bad because she is having cytophobia. But then after treatment, she recovered, and in 1870, she looks a lot better than she was 4 years ago. Our example for trofo is trophotropism. Trophotropism is a chemotropism in which food or a nutritive substance constitute the orienting factor, a affinity to food or nutrition. And the example for the suffix trophy is dystrophy. Dystrophy is a wasting of body tissues of genetic, or is either of genetic origin or due to inadequate or defective nutrition. Like the Miss A, when she's having cytophobia, we can say she's having dystrophy. Let's review what we've learned. For food, we can use the prefix cyto, S-I-T-O, or tropho, T-R-O-P-H-O, or we can use the suffix trophy, T-R-O-P-H-Y. And for nutrition, we can also use the suffix trophy, or as an adjective, we can use trophic, T-R-O-P-H-I-C. Let's see our example. For trophic, our example is autotrophic. Autotrophic, meaning of or pertaining to the production of organic compound from carbon dioxide as a carbon source, meaning these organisms, they can synthesize organic compound from very simple molecule like carbon dioxide, and the energy they use to synthesize these organic compounds is either light or reactions of inorganic chemical compounds. Then these organisms are called autotrophic organisms. And for nourishment, we have two prefix to use. One is nutri, N-U-T-R-I. Another one is tropho, T-R-O-P-H-O. Our example for nutri is nutriology. Nutriology is the science of nutrition, the study of food and their use in diet and therapy. For sugar, we have several prefixes to use, like glyco, G-L-Y-C-O, or mali, M-E-L-I, or malitol, M-E-L-I-T-O, or saccharol, S-A-C-C-H-A-R-O. And a lot of time, we can also use saccharide at the end of the word, but it is not officially a suffix, so that's why I use a different color to mark it. Our example for saccharol is saccharometer. Saccharometer, as shown in this picture, is a hydrometer used for determining the amount of sugar in a solution. It is invented by Thomas Thomson, and it's used primarily by winemakers and the brewers, and it can also be used in making sorbets and ice creams. And for saccharide, our example is polysaccharide. Polysaccharide is a polymer made of many saccharide units linked to glycosidic bonds. Like in this picture, the bread contains a lot of polysaccharide, which is starch. Let's review what we've learned. For sugar, we have glycol, G-L-Y-C-O, maltose, M-E-L-I, maltose, M-E-L-I-T-O, and saccharose, S-A-C-C-H-A-R-O. These four prefixes to use. And we can also use saccharide, S-A-C-C-H-A-R-I-D-E, at the end of the word to describe sugar. Now we finish the first part of lesson 18. Let's review what we've learned this time. For sharp or a sour taste, we use the prefix OX or oxy, OXY. For sweet and sweetness, we can use glucose, G-L-U-C-O, glycol, G-L-Y-C-O, maltose, M-E-L-I, and the maltose, M-E-L-I-T-O. For base, we can use basil, B-A-S-O. For bitter, we can use picrol, P-I-C-R-O. For food, we use cito, S-I-T-O, trofo, T-R-O-P-H-O, these two prefix, or the suffix trophy, T-R-O-P-H-Y. For nutrition, we can use these two suffixes, trophic, T-R-O-P-H-I-C, or trophy, T-R-O-P-H-Y. Trophic is used in adjectives. For nourishment, we can use these two prefixes, nutri, N-U-T-R-I, or tropho, T-R-O-P-H-O. For sugar, we can use glycol, G-L-Y-C-O, and maltose, M-E-L-I, and maltose, M-E-L-I-T-O, or saccharose, S-A-C-C-H-A-R-O, these four prefixes. And we can also use saccharide, S-A-C-C-H-A-R-I-D-E, at the end of the word to describe sugar. However, saccharide is not officially a suffix. Now we finish the first part of lesson 18. Next time when we come back, we'll learn more about the smell and the taste related prefixes and suffixes. See ya! English for Biology Major is brought to you by TCU's English for Biology Major course team. If you have any questions, don't forget to visit our FB fans page. The website is here, and you can also scan the QR code to reach to our FB fans page. This course is sponsored by Centers for Faculty Development and Instructional Resources of TCU.